Guys, do not try today's video at home. Seriously, I'm not joking. It's extremely dangerous.
Blood alert!
You've been warned.
Yo, what's up, ladies and gentlemen? It's your boy, and today I'm back with my boys. I got Chad with the J, Vaughn Gizzles, and we are going to be creating the most dangerous kids' toys of all time. Now, before we get started, I do want to give a big shout out to ADHD's World, who came up with this idea. If you guys want to see his version of it, go check it out. I'll leave a link in the description down below. Now, basically, what we are going to be doing is we have Nerf guns, Nerf bows, Nerf slingshots, and we are going to be attaching nails, razor blades, and a whole bunch of different items to make them. But yeah, we're gonna be attaching all of these sharp and pointy items onto these friendly kids' toys and turning them into tools of mass destruction.
So each of us is gonna get one of each item, and we're only gonna have 15 minutes to make it as dangerous as we possibly can.
Once we've made it as dangerous as absolutely possible, we are taking these tools of mass destruction to the test, and we're gonna be shooting shit.
And then it's gonna be up to you guys to decide who made the most dangerous toys. So before we get started, let us know who you think is going to make the most dangerous toys, and we'll see if you're right at the end of the video. All right, let's get started. Let's see what we can build. Okay, so this is dangerous to play with, but also to create. I cut my finger, Bongo cut his finger. Did you cut yourself?
Yeah, I cut myself.
You all hurt yourself.
I'm bleeding. You?
You're a genius.
That's for the slicing. It's what I like to call my popper. I need more thumbtack.
Bongo's making a collage.
Look at this. Bro.
Look at my finger.
Stop.
What the fuck?
How did you do? Is that from before?
Yeah, bro. Oh, I just haven't looked at it.
Blood alert!
Alright guys, so I am pretty much done. I'm waiting for the rest of the guys to just put the final touches on there. So this is arrow number one. Pretty simple, got a nice blade on top with a screw in the center. So my hope is that it'll puncture, make a little hole, and that'll allow for the blade to slide through more easily. Then we have arrow number two, which has the slicers on the side, the nails on top. And then I kind of cheated, I made a third arrow. And I modeled it after Bongo's ball, so it's just like a nice little death arrow filled with thumbtacks. So it won't puncture deep, but it'll puncture a bunch of different holes. Then I have some basic Nerf gun bullets. I just put the thumbtacks on top. So those should do a little bit of damage. Pop some balloons pretty easily, I'm expecting. And then this one's a little more heavy duty. I cut off the top and dug a screw into the center of the Nerf bullet. So we'll see how that does. And then this is my ball. So I did, again, kind of similar to Bongo's. I put a bunch of thumbtacks on either side, but I also put some nails in the center and one of the razor blades as well. So it's got a lot of different types of damage it can do. Puncture wounds, slicing, all that fun stuff. So I think this is gonna be really interesting to see how it does.
This little ball thing, I took two pieces of the razor, we broke them in half, and then one of the main razors, and basically I made like kind of like a cross of death. Then like I mentioned earlier, I took the biggest nail we had, popped it on. I just basically wanted this to be like a straight up.
It's like a harpoon.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. No messing about, you know, I didn't want anything else on the bottom of it, just a straight up nail in the middle. Look at that thing. And then I patented the cutoff technique to keep it still aerodynamic. So we have a screw in the middle of one, we have a thumbtack in the other, and then we have a nail which I sharpened with the razor blades
well.
Okay, so for my first arrow, I have a series of screws in the middle. They're all glue gun to the top, so that should be fun. And then my second arrow has more of a slice effect.
The
so
plug.
This is gonna be, I call this one the plug. This one's gonna be used for slicing things and flesh wounds and stuff like that. And then I have my ball of destruction.
That is the one I'm most excited to see.
The plug.
So this is like a mace looking ass. For the bullets, I kind of adapted the put it into the bullet technique. So my screw is actually in the bullet and glue gunned around
it. Sliced it open, eh?
Yeah, this one here, I used the surgical. This one's not gonna do shit, I don't think, but it looks pretty cool. Now this one, this is the banger of all bangers. So instead of digging in, I sliced around and kept one flap and flapped it open, put the thumbtack in, and then welded it back together.
That is
so
nice.
There's that
okay.
one.
That's nice.
All right, so now it is time for each of us to take our weapons and test them out on a few different items. The items that we are going to be shooting are a watermelon, a Coke bottle, we have some paper plates, some balloons, and then we have the ultimate balloon, the Super Wubble, which I've heard is unpoppable, so we're going to put that to the test today. Let's get started and let's see who made the most dangerous kid's toy of all time. Woo! Okay, so first up, we are going to take shots at the balloons with the Nerf bullets, and then we're going to move on to some bigger and better targets. All right, who wants to go first?
Shotty.
Okay, so just a standard nail in there.
Yep, firing in 3, 2, 1. Okay, so the nail was fully intact. This one, I'm curious about because we actually cut it open. So we'll see how it flies out of the gun.
Okay, so that is a thumbtack in there. Am I right? Yeah, thumbtack.
3, 2, 1.
Ooh!
Okay, if any of them aren't gonna work, it's gonna be this one because it's really heavy. The nail compared to like a thumbtack.
I don't know if you can see it, but it's a screw.
3, 2, 1.
Oh, no pop.
I think because the nail is so heavy, it obviously like didn't have as much power when it was launching. Yeah. It's harder to move it because it's so heavy. So
okay, so Jad has gone up. 2 out of 3 of his darts worked. Now it's Bongo.
The first one I'm going to be using is the thumbtack, the surgically placed thumbtack one.
Okay.
I think that one's going to be an Instapop. 3, 2. Here. That was a nice one. That was a nice papa's. All right, so the next one I'm going to be using is the combination of the nail gun cartridges here. So I put 4 of them, I'm pretty sure, in one, and then I glue gun them in. 3, 2, 1. Here.
Ooh. Oh,
last one. This is the screw-as. All right, so you're trying to escape, alive? 3, 2, 1. Here.
It jammed. Here. No, that's a dud.
It's a dud. Let's see it.
So it looks like the nails aren't really a good choice.
It's a little too heavy. I think that must be it. All right, I got my 2 Nerf bullets loaded in right now. So we have one that's just a classic thumbtack glued to the top and one where I chopped the rubber off and put the black screw in. I only made 2 because I was focused on doing other things. So I won't have 3 shots like the rest of the guys, but let's see how these do.
Ooh.
All right, guys.
I think it's a dud, bro.
This is a dud. You cannot use something heavy with these. You need something small like the thumbtacks or the nail. Moving on, we've got the classic thumbtack.
Ooh-wee.
So this should work.
That's so satisfying.
So one of mine didn't work, so I went 1 for 2. The rest of the guys went 2 for 3, so I guess you guys technically beat me on that round. But we are now moving on to bigger and better things. So let's see what we got. All right, so Jad, show us what you're working with for this.
Okay, so we're gonna go with the nail. You know, this is just a plain Jane. You know, I'm hoping this one does work. 3, 2, 1.
Ooh!
Here.
That's a nice stick. Ooh!
Gut my opponent.
Yo, that went deep.
Yeah, this was deep.
That would do work.
Success.
That would do work. Okay, so Jad only had 1 arrow, so next up is a Bongo. Let's see what you got, bro.
I'm gonna go with this concoction here, the multi-screw arrow. Ready?
Yeah.
3, 2, 1. Here!
Ooh!
Let's go! Multiple stab.
That's damage. Pull that out. Oh, bro.
I got the guts.
That's a green guts.
The green guts.
So you can see the lickle nice. It's like a shotgun.
Yeah. Like shotgun. Ooh, okay. Like
multiple stab wounds to the opponent. He's over.
Next one is the slicer. All right?
Okay.
So this one, it should slice the opponent and get stuck.
And puncture.
Yeah. Ooh. 3, 2, 1.
Oh no!
I lost the blade. This was a failed attempt, guys.
Okay, so for my first arrow, I got the thumbtack extraordinaire. It's just literally a bunch of thumbtacks on it.
Okay,
it hit it. But did it do damage?
Oh yeah, it did. Nails got stuck
in it. Oh,
that's nasty.
Oh shit! That's crazy. What? Okay, for arrow number 2, we've got 2 razor blades, but unlike Bongo's, they're on the side. So maybe that'll add some slicing action.
It was at this moment that he knew he fucked up.
Oh, I just sliced my finger, bro.
I don't know about that one, man.
I pulled this back onto my hand.
Yeah, I don't know about that one, bro.
That one doesn't work. That's unshootable. Okay, so next up we have the slicer on top.
and a nice little screw on top. So we've got a combination here. We'll see how it does.
The
slicer just flew right out. We're just going straight screw again because we lost the razor.
Ooh! Headshot!
I like that.
Okay, let's see. Oh, that's some nice damage.
That'll fuck someone's day up.
So that one worked. I think just overall the razors are overrated. They don't do shit, really. Okay, so for the next round, we're gonna be using our slingshot balls. Jazz gonna throw the plates out like skeet shooters. We're gonna try and hit it out of midair and see. We're gonna test our accuracy and our ball's ability to do work on these paper plates.
Ready?
Yeah.
Oh!
Oh! Got it!
That was a snipe. The wind took that.
Any damage?
Not really, no. Alright, we're just gonna close range the watermelon and see what happens.
Oh!
That should have boxed you in the leg. Jesus.
We lost the blade yet again.
Oh no, the blade stayed in. The blade stayed in.
Holy fuck, you're bleeding, bro.
Yeah, I'm bleeding a lot. Blood alert! Don't do this at home alert! We got one that stuck in and the nails stayed in there.
The nails actually stayed in there.
Pretty good. Bongo's got his mace death the ball, so let's see how this does.
All right, here we go.
All right. What happened?
It got stuck. I don't think this one's gonna fly. I think it's gonna get stuck again.
What the F? I don't get why it doesn't come out.
They're not working.
I think this isn't even the ball either. This is literally just this doesn't work. Just doesn't work, unfortunately. And this is the one I was most looking forward to seeing. So Jazz isn't gonna work either, but we can just stuff it in and see what it would do.
So this would be the cross blade. Oh,
yeah. Oh, that's stuck in nice. Oof. Okay, so what's been working the best so far is easily the arrows. So we're gonna continue using the arrows and try them on these two Coke bottles and see how much damage they can do and just see what happens to the Coke bottles in general when they're punctured by these arrows. First up, we got Bongo with the shotgun arrow.
Shotgun arrow.
I'm cheese. I forgot to set up the GoPro. No. Oh, yo, that was a box. Holy shit.
Oh my.
Where is it?
It's like cracked. It just broke.
Oh, shit. Really. Yeah. That was just pure impact. All right, Jad's got his harpoon.
Ready?
Yeah. That was sick. It's still bro, my phone got murked. GoPro got a little murked too.
I drink the guts.
How's that Coke taste?
My opponent's blood.
Here.
That's a neck. Oh, a neck shot.
Nice. A headshot, bro.
What? A lot of damage.
That was damage.
Yeah, that was nice. That was nice.
I like that. My opponent's blood.
Do not do this at home. I'm bleeding. Bongo's bleeding. Jad's bleeding. Do not try this at home. All right, Bongo has kindly allowed me to try the shotgun Big Mon on our last Coke bottle. So let's see what happens. They call me Robin Hood for a reason. Not because I take from the rich and give to the poor. I just shoot bone marrow.
That was a side gutter, yeah.
Oh,
I think just one or two of the nails caught it on the side.
Yeah.
Again. My opponent's blood.
But don't do this at home. Alright, last, the finale. We're gonna use these on the wobble and see if we can pop the unpoppable balloon. 30 minutes later and we finally filled up the wobble ball. Look how big this thing is.
Here.
Oh my god.
And I honestly think it could have even gone bigger. Yeah. I can't even get it in the shot. It's so big.
That's what she said.
Bro, I think you could sit on that thing.
I think you could too. I just don't want to try it. Okay, let's go.
Are you gonna try and sit on it? Imagine it just pops.
Bro!
No.
Okay.
All right, attempt number one. We've got bongo, shotgun, arrow. This doesn't work, I don't know what will.
That's the thing, we're gonna do it from a little bit of distance too.
Yeah, cause-
Oh my god, it's attacking me.
It's moving on its own.
Here we go.
Oh, first try! It worked! No way! Let's go! Oh my god!
Bro.
I was not expecting that.
Condom looking.
Bro, by the biggest D on earth. Bro, this is an elephant condom.
Ah, that was a joke.
Okay, that took like 30 minutes to set up and 0.3 seconds to finish. Here is the aftermath. Bongo's arrow did work, fam. Absolute work.
I think it's safe to say this was the most damaging one.
Yeah, I think so. Bongo, I think you won. But it's up to you guys, so let me know in the comment section below who you think had the most badass, the most damaging weapon. If you guys enjoyed today's video and you want to see a part two, be sure to smash that thumbs up button. If we can get over 25,000 likes on this video, we will do another part and maybe we'll take on some different items. But also, if you have any suggestions for things you think we should shoot next time, be sure to let me know in the comment section below. Also, I got to give a big shout out to my boy Bong Gizzles and Jad? Oh. I don't know where Jad is, but go subscribe to both of them. I'll leave links to both their channels in the description down below. As always, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will catch you next time. Toodles! Also, don't do this at home. Like, seriously, do not do this at home.
Don't do it at home.
Don't do it at home.
I'm warning you.
Professionals only.
I'm warning you.
Don't ever do it.
Don't do it.
Ever, Toodles.
Unless you have parents' supervision, and then you can
No, but still don't do it.
Don't do it.